Well, it's a pretty short week for you, a four-day trading week. But when we look at the performance in last week's trading session, it was a pretty good on that front.
I believe last week was pretty impressive, especially with a lot of positive performance in the construction and the banking stocks, given the fact that they had very positive fundamentals. We saw KCB, we saw Athi River Mining, Bamburi doing pretty well, and we also saw that a lot of shift in focus for foreign investors actually coming in from divesting from the bonds, treasury bill securities, into alternative options. Probably some of them went into equities, and that's where you saw a company like Athi River Mining actually really doing very well. Actually, on Wednesday did a maximum of a 10% trade, which is the allowed maximum per day.
Let's look at the construction sector. Like you say, Athi River Mining doing quite well. We also have Bamburi also doing quite well on the local bourse. Talk us through some of the major drivers of this positive momentum in these stocks.
What we've been able to see that there's a lot of demand for the products and services, especially occasion in the what you call the real estate, you know, construction industry, for both for commercial and residential purposes. We've seen a lot of expansion within the region, in Southern Sudan, in Rwanda, in Tanzania, and we've seen a lot of projects, infrastructure projects that the region has actually undertook. We've seen a lot of the firms actually working on the management systems to be able to reduce the cost of operations and be able to, you know, increase the book value. So we've seen that construction firms have been able to actually understand the essence of cutting down on cost of operations while still being able to maximize out in terms of output, in terms of streamlining how they're going to maximize on their control market share.
And the banking sector, like you also said, another attractive sector over there in Kenya. Now, banks are looking for new frontiers, entering new frontiers, are looking for opportunities to better returns going forward. The mobile money business is one of the avenues that banks are aggressively getting into. Talk us through what some of the banks are doing on that front.
For a while, banks were actually very afraid of M-Pesa, the mobile service money transfer product. And for a while, banks actually were looking for ways to actually either curtail the influence of M-Pesa or actually being able to deal and remove it from the system in terms of money transfers. And we've been able to see that banks like Barclays, KCB have been able to actually come out with their mobile transfer products where they have the API, where they're open to where you can be able to do money transfer to any network, whether you're registered or not. So this is actually the next frontier. And we're able to see that banks are actually looking for ways to be able to lock in the clients through convenience, through ease access of our services and products, and the convenience of a button. So we know that this is going to be the next frontier. Now, M-Pesa for the first time actually is going to get serious competition from the banks themselves. And if the banks can be able to control the money transfer services, and we're seeing that Barclays is actually targeting the diaspora, because we see we get over 6.7 billion every quarter from the diasporan markets, mm-hmm, in terms of remittances, and this is where Barclays is actually going to go. And given the exposure, the experience in this field, it's going to be very interesting to see how KCB and other banks are going to actually be able to control this issue also.
So all that likely to boost profits are going forward. But there's also been that whole debate around profits when looking at the banking industry and the high loan growth there. It's also talk about morality and that the banks are actually charging customers too much, and they should be looking at some sort of model of perhaps decreasing some of the rates that they are charging consumers at this stage, given the fact that they are making quite large profits.
True. The question of morality has now actually come up, especially when the last few weeks when banks have been able to release the impressive results, most of them are making a lot of our profits. So the question has been, while banks are actually, you know, making a lot of money, what's happening to the clients, the customers who are actually being squeezed in a corner in terms of the interest rates being paid to the loans they've been able to get, or the interest rates are being paid in terms of the money they've given the bank for deposit. So this is a question that's been unable to go away. We've seen the parliament has actually come into question to be able to control and curtail the aspect of the interest rates. But this is an issue where now banks have to be savvy and creative to be able to maintain their customers and be able to actually have what you call a morality sense in terms of doing business, trying to balance the motive issue of being fair to your customer and also being able to balance what the demands of your investors and shareholders demand of you in terms of profit returns. And I think this is one of the reasons that's giving rise to banks to be able to be creative, to come up with more innovative products that will actually ease and reduce the costs of operations and transactions so that banks can be able to give more value to their customers.
Let's look at the fixed income market. We did have foreign investors offloading about 1.8 billion Kenyan shillings in the treasury bills markets. Could you kindly talk us through that dynamic? Why are foreigners suddenly moving out of the treasury bill space?
For the last 2 or 3 months, the treasury bills were the ultimate place to invest money. The interest rates were very high, which meant the returns were good. However, given the decision that the central bank has been making in terms of trying to cushion the shilling against the fluctuating international factors, we've been able to see that the interest rates are dropping down, and hence the reason why foreign investors are actually pulling out of the treasury bills, because the returns have actually gone below what they expected. So the options are either to look for other return on investment in other markets, either diversify into the equities and change the strategy in terms of investment to long term, because now the treasury bills and government bonds actually, in terms of returns, actually reduced down, because we're seeing that the dropping interest rates that's happening in the market because of the fiscal and regulatory options and policy issues that central bank has actually put in place.